we will see the applications of polaroids or the phenomena of polarization. I have made a list of it. Number one, we use it to cut the glare. What is the glare? Glare we see in the eyes. In the daytime, when we see the headlight of a car, we don't call it a glare. But in the night time, when we see headlight of a car coming towards us, we are not able to see a scooter or a cycle which is going on the road. Then we say, I could not see the cycle because of the glare of the car light. What is this glare? This glare is lot of light, because of which we are not able to other things which are giving small light, less light. Because opening of our eye, that is opening of the pupil of our eye, it is a adjustable thing. By iris it is adjusted according to the source of the light. Source of the light is a cycle which is giving very less light, then this will open it large so that it get sufficient amount of light on the retina. Now it is getting a light which is required 100%, we are able to see the cycle. Suddenly a car comes here. If a car comes here, lot of light comes here, and now this light has become 200%. If the light has become 200% and retina cannot bear it, it will get damaged. What is the damage control? It immediately asks this pupil to decrease its size. So this window now decreases to half, this much. It was so large, it has become small. So this light which is coming 200, now this also become 100. And we can see the car headlight, but this size has become small. When this size has become small, from the cycle, this light which was coming to the large size as 100 rays, with the small size, now it can come only 25. 25 is not acceptable to the eye. What it needs? 100. Earlier, cycle was showing 100 because the size was large. Because of the light from the car, it has to reduce its size to make the car light as 100. So, with the reduced size, the light from the cycle has reduced to 25, so cycle is not visible. And we go and hit the cycle. And we say, what was the problem? The glare of the car was the problem. This is the problem. This is called glare. Then how Polaroid helps it? See, at the car, when the light comes, there are both vibrations. This vibration and this vibration on the headlight of the car. On the headlight of the car, we use this type of Polaroids. Vertical Polaroids. So, which light is now coming? Answer, vertical light is coming to our eyes. Okay. These vertical lights are coming to our eyes. Yes. And when these vertical lights fall on the ground, this, what will happen? This will get absorbed. Sorry, let me put it other way. From here, the light has got both the vertical one is absorbed on the road and it reach my eyes, then the intensity has become half. Why? I have used Polaroid here. From the headlight of the car, I am using the Polaroids, and because of this Polaroid, the intensity becomes half. When that intensity becomes half, then this effect also decreases. So, then I am not having the glare. So, this Polaroid material used before the headlight, that is sufficient to show him the ground. Why? It gives only one direction of the vibrations. Okay, so this one type of vibrations are cancelled, therefore we get less light, less intensity of light, because it has become polarized. So that is how we can cut the glare of the car. Now, the second thing is in 3D movies. In three-dimensional movies, it's a long technique. For 3D movies, we have to see, we have to replicate the method of seeing with two eyes. How do we see with two eyes? If I am seeing this face, I am seeing this face from two eyes, then this eye looks this portion of the face and this eye looks this portion of the face. This portion is different than, this eye looks this and this. You see, this eye can look this ear, this eye can look this ear, this cannot see this ear, and this eye cannot see this ear. So, these are our two eyes. So, there are two different images made by the two eyes. These two images are sent to brain. Brain processes them and he makes a figure, three-dimensional figure, okay? And he is able to make this figure, okay. Whatever it was, the original shape, he make that original shape. That is a sculpture. He is able to make a three-dimensional sculpture with help of these two images, because they were taken from the different angles. If you see from one angle, you will not be able to measure the depth of any material. These are the two points. If I see it from here, I cannot say which is in front and which is in the back. If we have another eye, then this angle is large, this angle is small, and then brain has understanding that this is in front with the large angle and this is on the back side with small angle. So what is required? Two pictures are required, and this angle decides the depth of any particular material. So depth made by our ears, angle made by our ears is always less than the angle made by our nose. If I put my hand this way, it is making bigger and bigger angle to you. That is why you see it, that it is coming closer to you and you are using both the eyes. Now, so we need two pictures, two separate pictures, and one visible by this eye, other visible by this eye. But unfortunately, screen before us is only one. So we have developed a technique. On that screen, we project two pictures. One picture which one camera is taking from this side, other picture which other camera is taking from this side. Both pictures are taken by two cameras. One from this side, one from this side. Then both these pictures are projected on the screen together. When you project these two together, in one picture you find the nose is here, in the other picture you find the nose is here. Slightly different it has to be, because the cameras are at different angles. Okay, now we have to show to the brain two images separately, so that this eye send one picture, this eye send another picture, and this eye should not send the picture which is seen by this eye, and this eye should not send the picture which is seen by this eye. How we can do that? Here we can do it by Polaroids. How can we do it by Polaroids? The one shooting with this camera is done by ordinary rays, and this one shooting is done by extraordinary rays. Ordinary rays which have vibration like this. All the light is polarized light, this vibration. And this camera, all the light which has got this vibration. Okay, both are making images. Both images we put there. In our eyes, we can see both the images. But when we have that polaroid glass, this polaroid glass has a polaroid which allows only this rays. It will not allow this ray. So what will happen? If it does not allow this way, the photograph of this camera is not visible to this eye. This is seeing only one image, which is in this light. Similarly, this glass has got a system which will show, which will allow only extraordinary or this vertical vibrations. This will not allow this vibration. So, the image of this camera, which was done in this vibration, is not allowed by this glass. So, this will see only one image. Which image? This will see this image, this one. And this glass is seeing only this image. Now, this is comparable as how we see the things live. How we see the things live? One eye from this side, one eye from this side. This is not seeing this, this is not seeing this. That we have created by cancelling. This will show only this side of picture. This will show only this side of picture. So both images are sent to brain, and brain make a sculpture of that, and he makes a three-dimensional figure of that, and it appears to as if somebody is live before us. Here we have used polaroids when we are photographing. Here we polarized light is used in photography, and we have used polaroids to filter them when we are seeing the picture. That is why in all your 3D TVs you have the goggles with them. That is necessary. And this you can do all the experiments with those goggles. Those are polaroid. See something in this. See, have the other goggle. You see something here and put it here, rotate it. You will see everything what I have told you. And it will be very interesting. You will find it. So, next time, do it with the glasses of 3D. You will find that polarization effect. Okay. Now, even if you see any reflected light with that, you can find out whether it is polarized or not. I am seeing this picture with that glass, one glass. And I rotate it. If by rotating the intensity of the light does not change, then it has vibration in all the direction and it is an unpolarized light. But if by rotating I find the intensity is becoming less, that means it is already a directional one. It shows full light, then it shows no light, half the light. This you can see by those glasses, and that's a wonderful thing in your house. So that is 3D movies. Then in the photography, same thing, we want to cut the glare. So when we don't want to change the colors and we do the photography only if sunlight is less. We cannot make the sunlight less, nor we want to use any color so that color will come in the picture. We don't want color in the image. We don't want that much sun. So what we can do? We can use a polaroid which will cut one side of vibrations and intensity will become half. So we will have a beautiful picture with photography filters. Then polaroid sunglasses. Same thing for the sunglasses. Polaroid sunglasses have a specialty that they do not decrease, they should not mix up color with the image. With the ordinary glasses we use, sunglasses, they are mixing certain colors and they are cutting other colors. Like if I use pink glasses, then it will cut the blue color of the light which is coming to me, and anything blue I see, that will appear to me black. If I have blue glasses, grey glasses, blue glasses, and I see a rose, the rose will look black because it will allow blue color, it does not allow red color to come. That is the problem with our colored glasses. But if we have polaroid glasses, it will allow all the seven colors. What it will cut? It will cut one side of vibrations. So the total intensity become half, and in place of sun, the things appear to us as if they are placed in shade. So that gives a very soothing effect. So the polaroid glasses are better than ordinary sunglasses because they do not give any type of color defects. Then windows of airplanes, we use it so that it will cut the light, and that light may also be damaging because at the height there are ultraviolet lights, there are more powerful lights, and we want to cut that glare. So we use it in the windows of aeroplane. Then it is also used to improve the color contrast in the pictures. It is also used in LCD screen. If you have studied about LCD, LCD TV, LCD screen in our laptop, LCD in our mobile, or in our calculator, especially calculator. What happens in that? How those black figures appear? Whenever we press a button, that particular area becomes a little hot. When that becomes hot, the chemical there convert into light. Chemical there which was solid convert into liquid. What it has become? Liquid crystal. So if there is, these are the crystals, you know there are 8 crystals like this, yes, this way. So if you switch on 8, the current will go in all these 8 crystals. What will happen? They, because of that current, they will become liquid. Liquid crystals. When they become liquid, what happens? Answer is, when they become liquid, they become polaroids. Their construction is such that they become polarized. And when they become polarized, the intensity of light coming through them is cut. So if the light is not coming from this place, how it will appear? Black. So this is LCD, and it was solid, current was given, it has become liquid crystal. But after that, why black? Answer, because it does not allow light to pass through unpolarized. It makes it polarized. And the moment it makes it polarized, then the intensity is gone and it appears to be black. So this is LCD. Again, polaroids are used in LCD. Again, we have chemical analysis. There is polarization of the light. You have seen the light turning. The light turn also due to polarization, and this turning, this polarization of a particular, this is the vibration direction passing through a crystal. This will turn like this, then this will turn like this. In some crystals, this will turn this way. We call this turning, one turning is levo, one turning is dextro. You have studied it in chemistry, so I need not tell you more, but that is what? What is levo and dextro? That is turning of the vibrations, that is polarization, and that help us to find out, to do the chemical analysis of the many chemicals. So there are so many uses of polarization, and new things we are searching for polaroid uses. So this was all about applications of polaroid. Thank you.